Set.
Dalila Muhammad's quest to defend her gold medal begins now.
And watch for Dalila. She is masterful in the first half of this race. She is off to a blistering pace, already overtaking Anna Cockrell. Sydney Mclaughlin much more relaxed down this backstretch.
And this is the way that she won the Olympic gold the last time we were at the Olympic finals. But Sydney Mclaughlin is about a half step behind with half the race gone. I think she has run the first half just right, and now she's gonna make her move to try to get back in touch with the Olympic champion.
This is what happened at the World Championships. Mclaughlin had to run down Dalila Muhammad. Mclaughlin checks fellow 21-year-old Femke Bol off the list. Now it's the race to the line. Sydney Mclaughlin is bringing it to Dalila Muhammad. Muhammad's trying to hold on. Mclaughlin on the inside to the line. It's going to be Sydney's time again, and it's a world record again. Mclaughlin 51.47 blows her 51.90 away.
So for a long time growing up, I viewed being a follower of Christ as you can't do this, you can do this. These are your restrictions and limitations of what's good and what's bad. But I didn't think there was any freedom in that. And I was afraid that in doing that, I would be handing over my individuality and my identity. So I kind of put that off and just walked in the world and lived a very secular life, and it never fulfilled me, it never sustained me, and I could vividly hear God in a couple instances just be like, are you done? Like, are you ready to give your life over to me? Are you ready to let me have control? And I would literally tell him no, because I wasn't sure that in doing that, it would turn out the way that I wanted it to turn out. You know, there's been a lot of talk that I've received just about, you know, you may not want to talk so much about that. You might lose endorsements, you might lose deals, this, that, and the third. But I mean, I don't live for the approval of people, so I don't have to worry about any of those things. And even if an endorsement or something wants to leave, I know that God will provide for me in the way he sees fit. So I'm not going to compromise the truth just to make people feel more comfortable.
Be able to see. My next essential item is my necklace. It says all for God. Right before any race, I kind of just think about it and focus on what it is I'm doing and what I'm going out there to do, which is glorify and honor God. I ordered this actually right before the Olympic trials last year, just as something that I could put on, kind of like getting ready for war almost. I've been working on memorizing Colossians 1, 13 and 14. He has delivered us from the domain of darkness and transferred us to the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. This is my bigger MacArthur Study Bible that I love. It has not only the text, but on the bottom it has descriptions that help you have a deeper understanding of what you're reading. Being able to dive deeper into God's word wherever I am with whoever I'm with is just such a crucial part of my life and my daily process. So my Bible is my lifeline, and I just got this mini one because it fits in any purse, any bag, anything like that. I'm already starting to mark it up and everything.